All right, welcome everyone. Hurricane season's coming up, and I've always wanted one of these portable power stations as a backup to charge important devices like computers and cell phones if the power ever goes out. So I was excited when Oupes reached out to me to provide this portable power station for today's review. It has some interesting features that sets it apart, like this LiFePO4, also known as lithium iron phosphate battery, which is a newer, supposedly safer battery technology, has pretty decent capacity at 595 watt hours, and the ability to recharge from multiple power sources, including solar panels, which would also make it great for camping. So let's open up this box and see what's inside. Okay, so here you have your cable. But what cable? I'm not sure. Let's find out. Okay, this looks like a regular AC three-prong cable right here. It looks like we have a 12-volt cigarette adapter for car charging with a barrel connector on the end. This box is labeled adapter. Inside here we have some instructions for the 600-watt portable power station. There's a warranty card included. And then here's the AC adapter that would go with this cord I just showed. And then the Oupes power station is safely nestled here between these foam pads. So let's take this guy out now. It does have some heft to it. Go ahead and measure that in a second. So I just discovered the light, which is a nice little feature here. Oh, there's two settings. And it looks like this is an SOS mode because I speak SOS. Or maybe I read part of the instructions. So I would say, you know, in the room, this is pretty bright. I could see how that would be pretty useful at night, you know, to carry around a flashlight. Shut that off, spin it around a little bit. So this looks like where you would insert the 12 volt to 30 volt input source to charge it up. And now on this side is where you've got your LCD screen readout, which is nicely protected. You have your power, two 110 volt, 600 watt rated outlets, a 12 volt 10 amp plug with two connectors here. Here we have a 60 watt USB-C port and two USB-A ports rated at USB 3.0. It's like there's a button to control that. We'll get into that later once I figure out what I'm doing. Let's turn on the power button. So we have a nice little fancy charge circle here, reading at 80% pre-charged. So for those of you that need to carry this around, like in a camping situation, you're probably concerned about the weight. So let me go ahead and put this on a scale first and see how much this weighs. All right, so now for the official weigh-in. Reads about 15.6 pounds. So the first thing that the instructions recommend is that we plug in our portable power station and charge that to 100%. So here I am just joining the included power cord with the included power brick. And we're gonna plug that in. Just spin that around and plug that into the barrel connection on the side. Now that the power station's been plugged in, I have some exciting new charging lights showing up on the screen and the internal fans going. I'm gonna put the microphone closer now so that you can hear what it sounds like. On the front of the screen here, you can see the input is changing between 93 and 94 input watts, and we're still at 80% charging. This icon here appears to indicate that the fan is running to keep the battery cool while it's charging. We're at about 82% here on the power station. I'm gonna try charging now on all three USB ports that we have available to us. So here I have an iPhone 7, plug that in the bottom USB port, and now I'm gonna go take the iPhone XR and plug that up here. And lastly, I'm gonna plug in the USB-C port to charge an iPad. Nothing is shown as charging yet, but I think I need to push this button. So let me try that. There we go. Everything instantly just lit up for charging, including the iPad. And we have a really nice cool readout here at the top of the Oupes power station showing the output watts. Right now with the screens kind of off, we're drawing about 11 watts between those three different Apple devices. And I'm gonna turn the screens back on and see if the watt usage increases. And now with all the device screens on, we're actually at about 25 output watts and the fan's not even going right now. At the bottom, which is awesome, we have the actual remaining time based on the watts up here. So at 25 output watts, we have about 17 hours remaining. And it seems like these indications for USB-C and both USB-A's will light up based on what's plugged into it. So if I unplug the iPad, the USB-C indication goes off. When I plug it back in, it comes back on the screen. If I do that for the USB-A ports though, doesn't seem to show anything like that, which is an interesting difference, but not a deal breaker at all. All right, so now I'm gonna attach my MacBook Pro, so I'm gonna plug that into the AC outlet here. And now that I've done that, I'm going to push the power button on the bottom to liven up the ports. And so now if I plug in the MacBook, you have a charging indication here at the top. Now with all the devices running, we have about a 9.2 hour runtime with 35 output watts. All right, now that it's nice and sunny out, I'm gonna go ahead and test the Oupes Portable Power Station with solar charging. So I'm gonna take the included 7909 cigarette adapter that came in the package, and I'm gonna take the barrel connector and plug it into the side here. All right, in the back here for this test, we're gonna use this 30 watt Renogy solar panel, but the Oupes Portable Power Station can support up to 100 watts over this DC 7909 input. And just to make things easier for myself, I'm gonna use the positive and negative battery terminal clamps that came with this solar panel, so I don't need to do any kind of splicing or wiring to make this magic happen. And on the 7909 connector, these outer kind of spring clamps are going to be our negative connection. So we're going to just go ahead and clamp that on for now, just for a temporary test. And this connection right here is going to be for our positive. Now let's go ahead and take this solar panel into the sun. All right, so it's about 5 million degrees out here right now, but I'm going to try and get some volt readings here on camera. So we're getting a little bit over 17 volts off of the 30 watt solar panel right now. And I'm going to plug the cigarette adapter into the Oupes power station now to see if we're getting a charge. So you can see we're fluctuating between like 3 to 5 input watts off the panel right now, depending on the cloud conditions above me. But again, this is like a hobby solar panel. It's only like 30 watts. You can go up to 100 watts on this. And with the proper connector, you should probably get a little bit better of a charge. And that might be able to get you a little bit more runtime if you're in a pinch out in a camping situation. So now in a useful camping or survival situation, we've moved here to the garage. I'm gonna try and run this 120 volt air compressor off of our Oupes portable power station here. So here we have 81% charge. And I'm going to turn this guy on. See, it's peaking out at about 120 output watts. And still the station's doing quite well at 3.7 hours remaining. All right, so now we're in my garage and I've got this 42-inch Fire TV plugged into the Oupes power station down here. It's using 86 watts. We have 98% battery charge, which gives us a 5.4 hour runtime. The inverter doesn't appear to be struggling at all. It's about 86 degrees in the garage right now. Thank you, Florida. And I don't hear the fan going at all. So this would be a great option if you're in a situation where power's gone out and you need to see some critical news information, perhaps due to a blackout, or maybe you're camping or glamping, I guess, at that point. So yeah, it doesn't appear that this Oupes power station has any issues at all keeping up. All right, so now we're in my car and we're gonna go ahead and try to charge up now off of the cigarette lighter adapter that comes with the power station. So here I am plugging in. Sitting shotgun is my power station. So I'm plugging him in. Let's see what kind of indications we get on the front here. So except we're getting about 48 to 49 input watts. So this also works pretty good. So now while I'm sitting here in my car charging up enjoying the air conditioner, let's go over some of the interesting technical specs here in the manual. So as far as input's concerned, you have the 7909 charger, which I'm using right now, which is just another way of saying the barrel plug, and that's rated at 100 watts max input. You can also charge over that USB-C port I was showing earlier, and that's capped out at 60 watts maximum. The rated capacity of the battery is 595 watt hours, and that is rated at 19.2 VDC. And again, this is a lithium iron phosphate, or LIFE PO4 battery, which is incredibly hard to say. But this is the newer style lithium technology. Again, it's supposed to be safer. And since it is still lithium, it is much lighter than the equivalent lead acid battery would be. Again, this is about, all in all, about 15 and a half pounds weighed. It's waterproof to IP21 standards. It can go between 0 and 40 degrees Celsius working temperature. And down at the bottom here, we have the net weight listed at 6.8 kilograms. Alexa, what's 6.8 kilograms converted to pounds?
6.8 kilograms is about 15 pounds.
So that's about right. All right, and before you go, please consider subscribing to my channel for more great tech reviews, leaving me a comment down below if you have any questions. Thanks for watching.